Kubo sliding it into the box. Brenner. Brenner puts it past Preza, but the flag goes up and the goal will not stand. Brenner thought he had his second.
Welcome to another edition of Instant Replay presented by Cheez-Its. It's week 20. I'm missing my partner in crime, Andrew Wiebe, who's in LA, sunny LA, enjoying the weather for All-Star. But that's okay. The show must go on. Let's head to Cincinnati. It's the 32nd minute, and Yu Yakubo finds himself in space. Now playing off the defender's back shoulder, Brenner takes off. The ball is weighted perfectly. Go! Whoa, whoa, whoa. The flag is up. Let's take a closer look. Was Brenner truly offside? In my opinion, when we slow it down, producer Rich, let's freeze frame. Right here, you can see that Brenner looks to be level with Camacho, who's keeping him onside. In my opinion, Brenner is in an onside position, and this goal should have stood. It's the 74th minute, and it's 0-0. Cincinnati are in possession, and Brenner finds himself in a 1v1 situation with Montreal's Camacho. He takes him 1v1, gets by, and goes down. The whistle's blown, and Camacho sees his second yellow and is sent off with a red. In my opinion, Rami Tuchon got this spot on. Camacho dives in, misses the ball, catches the right foot of Brenner, as you can see right here when we zero in. Worthy of a second yellow. Good job, crew. Let's move on. Let's head to New York. The Red Bulls are taking on the crew. It's the 6th minute, and there's a ball thrown into the box for Patrick Klimala. He's holding off Waylon Francis, and Liam Fraser comes over to help. The ball pops up, and Liam Fraser wins the ball. Or does he? Chris Penso blows his whistle and points to the spot. But wait a second. VAR official Jose Carlos Rivero signals to Chris Penso to take another look. Chris Penso goes to the monitor, and as you can see, Liam Fraser does win the ball and does not make contact with Liam Fraser. Good job, crew. They got this one right. We head to New England, where the Revolution are taking on DC United. It's the 63rd minute, and Arnór Tristesson is picking up a second ball. Yamil Assad, tracking back, tries to pick his pocket. He thinks he gets there, but Tristesson goes down, and Ted Uncle blows his whistle for a foul. Yamil Assad was already on a yellow card. Should he have seen a second yellow for this challenge? In my opinion, Yamil Assad is attempting to play the ball. He gets his foot in front of Tristesson, but does not make contact with the ball. Tristesson catches Assad's foot in the act of passing, which leads to him going down. For me, this is a careless foul, which under the laws of the game does not warrant a yellow card. Ted Uncle did a good job of keeping his card in his pocket. Now let's move on to the 72nd minute, where this time it is Tristesson, who is already in the yellow, making a tackle on Yamil Assad in the attacking half. He's rushing into the attacking third, and Tristesson, who's late, catches Yamil Assad's back leg, and Yamil Assad goes down. For me, this is a reckless challenge. Arnór Tristesson does not make contact with the ball and catches Yamil Assad, who's making a run into the attacking third. By laws of the game, this is a yellow card, and Arnór Tristesson was sent off. Ted Uncle got this call right. We head to Fort Lauderdale, where Inter Miami is taking on the Chicago Fire. It's 2-2 in the 71st minute, and Inter Miami are in possession. And then center back for Chicago Fire, Carlos Terán, goes down. Baldomero Toledo blows his whistle. It appears that Robbie Robinson elbowed Carlos Terán to force him to go down. VAR official Rubio Vasquez signals to Toledo to take a look at the monitor. As you can see on this replay, Robbie Robinson does make contact with Terán, but for me, it does not meet the criteria for violent conduct. Let's take a look at what violent conduct states. Violent conduct is when a player uses or attempts to use excessive force or brutality against an opponent when not challenging for the ball, regardless of whether contact is made. It also states a player who, when not challenging for the ball, deliberately strikes an opponent on the head or face with the hand or arm is guilty of violent conduct unless the force used was negligible. In my opinion, it is not a red card. The contact made was not with excessive force, and the contact was not significant enough. The crew did a good job of getting this one right. We head to Nashville, where it's the 28th minute, and they have a 1-0 lead against Orlando City. Leal plays the ball into the box for an on-rushing Hany Mukhtar. He goes down, and he looks at Fotos Pizakos for a pen. Play on, play on. Did they get this call right? In my opinion, João Moutinho does make contact ever so slightly, but not enough to warrant a pen. It's the 77th minute, and Nashville's Alistair Johnson seemingly goes down into the box, but no foul. Did Fotos Pizakos miss a pen? In my opinion, The contact this time that João Moutinho makes should have been a foul, but just outside the box. If we zero in, producer Rich, we can see that, in my opinion, the contact made was just outside the box and Fotos Pasacco should have called the foul. Well, it's a wrap for this edition of Instant Replay. I'm your boy Chuck. See you next time.